Hello everyone, welcome to the Java course. When we do the looping, it seems that we need to execute the content inside the loop every time. Actually, can we have some mechanisms to leave the loop if some condition is met? Or is it possible for us to skip one loop and do the rest of the looping? It is possible to do so when we can make use of the break and continue command. So let us see some examples of using the break and continue commands. Now I will introduce the break command first. Suppose I want to increment the variable to a certain amount until I reach the end point, which is 40. While the value is smaller than 80, I will add the step size to the value. I can use this instruction, value plus equal step. It means that I'm going to do the assignment statement like this. I want to have the value to become the value plus step. During the addition, it is possible that we will already reach the end point. So if it is the case, we want to discontinue the looping. Okay, if the value is larger than the value of the end point during the looping, I will break the while loop. It means that I will leave the whole while loop and do the instructions following the close and curly bracket. Okay, let me save it and run it. Okay, I will get this result. Value is originally equal to 0. So when 0 is smaller than 80, I will do the thing inside the while loop. Value would become 6 because the step size is 6. When the value becomes 6, it is still not larger than the endpoint. So I don't leave the while loop, I will simply do the printing inside the while loop. Same for 12, 18, 24, 30, and 36. But when the value becomes 42, the value is already larger than the endpoint. So I will leave the while loop by using the break command here. And after breaking the while loop, I'm going to print out the value when the instruction is already outside the while loop. So when I use the break command, I will leave the while loop and do the execution or the command followed by the while loop. So I will have this string coming out. In addition to using the break command, we can use the continue command so that we can skip some of the steps inside the while loop. So let us see some examples. I have some similar idea to the first one, but now I would use the continue keyword. Now I use the word continue. If the value 2 is equal to endpoint 2, I don't do the rest of the command followed by the continue keyword. What does it mean by that? I'm not going to execute the code following the keyword continues. So it means that I don't do the printing when this condition is met. What will I do instead? I will go to the beginning of the while loop so that I will go to the condition checking again so that I will do the loop again and again. That means if this condition is met, I will skip one iteration. So let us see the result by saving it and running it. Okay, I can print out 10 because originally the value of value 2 is 0. After the addition, it becomes 10. 10 is not equal to the endpoint 2, which is 40. So I will do the printing. Same for 20 and 30. But when value 2 becomes 40, which is equal to the value of endpoint 2, I don't do the printing. What will I do instead? I will go back to the original while condition and I will do the checking again, and I will go to do the looping again. So I will have value 2 equals 50, and since 50 is not equal to endpoint 2, which is 40, I don't do the continue action. Instead, I will do the printing. So I will print 50. Same for 60, 70, and 80. When value becomes 80, we will not do the printing. So the loop ends. I hope that you are able to understand the meaning of break and continue after following my examples. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.